Okay, so welcome to our live instructional webinar designed to support MemoryBook Online Yearbook Program. Today, we will be focusing on functions that relate to building activity or candid pages. Specifically, we will be reviewing page bleach and margins, the toolbar, design functions, and going over templates, working with templates, and how to take our templates and save them as your own. We'll also then kind of cover how to apply the custom theme art that is there. Okay. So one thing that we're going to get going, I just hear already in the designer, so I'm going to switch over off my little intro page here and kind of bring up this. So the first thing, I'm going to go ahead and just kind of move some stuff in here. We're going to just go ahead and, you know, when you get in here, what you're looking at here. And there you go. Just try to get everything to a blank slate here. So when you first come into the designer and you're looking at one of our pages, first thing you're going to notice is there are, you know, a couple different colored lines on here, and also kind of looks like a grid pattern. And you know, kind of an outer, kind of a darker gray spot here on the page. So we're going to go over all what that means. So when you're looking at this, the inside blue margin here, this blue line here, this is your inside margins. All pictures and text that you keep within this area are considered safe and not at risk of being trimmed or anything. So really, you'll want your photos in here, you want your text in here, primarily. Now moving on to the outer edge of the page, to where this this darker gray area here, this is the bleed area, and this red line here, this is our estimated trim line. Now the reason we say it's an estimated trim line is because during production there could be up to a 1/8 inch variance there, and that kind of depends on, you know, production factors, as you know, how thick is the stack they're cutting, you know, how sharp is blades on the trimmer, how's the machine running overall, and also just could be a difference in trim operators too. So that's why there could be up to, you know, 1/8 inch variance there. Now this outer area here, I'm gonna zoom in. This outer area here, this is our bleed area. So if I stick a little square out here, you kind of notice that backgrounds and anything that you have going out to the very far edge, you'll notice they'll have this little bit of lighter area here, just where that estimated trim line is. This is the area that's estimated to be trimmed off in production. And this is why it's going out into the bleed. Now, the term bleed in terms of printing just means full color that extends beyond the edge of the page. And what that will help with, as long as you have your backgrounds, or even if you do collage pages where you stick you know, backgrounds or images into the bleed, that just ensures that when your book goes to be trimmed, that you'll have full color running to the edges of your paper there. You won't have any kind of unsightly, you know, kind of edging or anything like that. Now with that in mind, just before we go and kind of talking about the bleed here, when building candid or activity pages, you can start off by either using a template, which we're going to kind of show you that today, but you are able to just drag and drop images that you've uploaded onto a page. And if like if you're doing a collage page, you can just drag and drop images onto the page, size them to liking, and then, you know, stick them all around the page. If you do decide to do the collage method, just some things to look out with your photos, especially where you're placing them and then what available room you have. So on an image like this, it's cropped down right to the top of this kid's head here. So when you're making a collage page like this, we're going to go over the areas where this photo would work out really well, or photos kind of similar to it. So images that, if you're doing a collage, that you stick out to the bleed, you'll want to stick parts of the image out that have, you know, a lot of background area or area of the photo that doesn't, you know, it's not cutting off anything at risk, like a face or anything, or it's just, you know, kind of empty area or space that it won't matter if that's trimmed. So on a photo like this, just on a page, this image is going to play, it'll work well if it's out to the bleed on the outside of the page, because only this little part's getting trimmed. So the boys here are, you know, the students here, they're still well within the margin line. They are not at risk of, you know, anything important about them being trimmed off. The same as if we move this image over into the gutter area, you know, we just have some background of the classroom being trimmed off and barely a little part of his shirt. So again, safe here. Image is going to be safe if it goes down to the bottom. You're just moving a little bit. They are still well, their faces are still well within the margins. The one spot on this page that this image wouldn't work well, or an image like this wouldn't work well, is if it's at the top of the page. Because this photo is already cropped down to right to the top. So if we push it out to the bleed even more, we're going to be taking more of this student's head off here, right here. Now, again, with that eighth inch variance in trimming, so let's say that the things ran short or fell short. I'm just going to bring the guide. I'm going to pull a guide down and bring it in. So if I bring it in just a little bit more, maybe it's a, yeah, it's just a little hair off or something, and it captures a little more. So this is kind of what we're trying to avoid right here, is, you know, faces or anything important being trimmed off. Now, it's just to avoid embarrassment to the student, or, you know, just, you know, you don't want half heads cut off there in your pages. But yeah, that's exactly kind of things you're kind of looking for if you have photos like this. You know, look to see where they would play best. If you're working a collage page, you're always looking to, you know, the area of the photo that you always want to stick out to the edge would be, you know, empty space or space that it doesn't affect if it's trimmed off. All right, so that's covering our bleeds and margins, just to give you the layout of page and your safe areas to stay within. I'm gonna go ahead and save this here real quick and leave this here. Okay, so from moving on from here, just going to go over some tools here that you will be working with, or to familiarize yourself where these are at. I'm actually going to zoom in on my browser here just a little bit so I can show these menus better. So when you're working on the top toolbar, just to go through these kind of quick, just a basic rundown. Under the file menu, this is where you're going to find your save. Like if you're working on anything to save your progress, go under file and do save. The save option is also a shortcut on your bar. And for those old enough here, this is a little 3.5 floppy disk here, what that looks like. But that's your save button. So if I move something here on the page, you'll now see that that's lit up. So I can either save from here, or just go and do file save to save my progress. Also under file, you are gonna find where you have save as template. So if you've taken any one of our layouts and modified it for your own use, or you have built your own template and saved it and want to save it, this is where you'll go. Other things you'll find here, click and go, you'll find more in the guide, but they're just smaller little grouping of elements. They're not full page templates. This is also where you can come and find page info. Like if you need to quickly find if a page has been assigned or anything like that, or if you need to mark it complete. You're also going to view PDF. Now this is if you want to do a proof of your page, like if you've got a page built up, you'd like someone to review it, you want to just do a quick printout, you can do view PDF. This option is also a shortcut here. It's preview page, the little printer icon there on your top toolbar. Those are the options under file. Moving under edit, this is where you're going to have your standard undo and redo. These are also shortcuts here on the top toolbar. We do have, as far as when you're working, we have cut, copy, paste, and delete. We also, if you're familiar with keyboard shortcuts for these, to cut, Control X, copy is Control C, paste is Control V as in Victor. Now, if you're working on a Mac or another Apple device, this would be the Command key. So it'd be Command X, Command C, Command V. Moving down under Edit, another really handy thing, I'm just going to pull it up right now. It's this Change Background. So if I pull up Change Background, this is going to pull up a backgrounds menu that you can, you know, change out your backgrounds on the page or do solid color. We're going to come back around to this a little bit later, but I just wanted to show you, it's a nice, you know, it's a nice little menu to keep up. You can, it's floating, you can keep it around, reposition it. But if you do, if you, you know, kind of done with it, you can click the X on it. But just remember, you can always pull that back up by going under the Edit menu and change background. If you have certain shapes or photos selected, the change shape option will change that to anything else. So I just changed that to a circle there. Under Edit, you also find and replace and spelling. Now this will be for your text editing options to help with spell check and that. And then one of the last things under here is select. Select is going to allow you to grab hidden while, so the select is going to kind of allow you to select everything on the page if you want to clearly take it off. Select just images or text boxes or that, or let's say you're looking for locked elements or anything incomplete. Doing a select incomplete will kind of help later down the road when you're getting ready to complete and submit your pages. This will help you find if there's anything like an empty text box or empty photo box that will kind of help there. So that's what our select options are. Under view, you're going to have things like hide rulers, hide page margins. Usually you just want to keep, you know, the rulers showing and the margins showing. Grids and guides. So if the grids are here on the page, you can hide those. There's also a toggle down here in the bottom. So if I click this little toggle, it'll toggle the grids on and off there. And we're gonna go through, we have our zoom in, zoom out, and fit in window. So if you need to increase the zoom on your page, you can do that from this menu. Now, this is also a shortcut in the upper right here. So you got a little plus and minus where you can zoom in, zoom out, or if you want to just hit fit page to fit everything to show there. And then down at the very last thing under view, this is where we have facing pages and single page. So right now, two page spread, this is going to be facing. Single page, there are some advisors that do kind of like to work on one page at a time, so you can do single page. Other than that, I mean, you're fine to leave stuff up as facing pages working through the program. Now, if you are an advisor that has a yearbook class and is assigning pages, ideally we would, it's better to assign one student to a two-page spread to assign them to both pages. But if you do have those instances where you have one student assigned to the left and a different one assigned to the right, what you may have what both of those students do is when they go to work on the book, have them both switch to a single page just to avoid any save errors. Because really, ideally, you're only supposed to be, you know, one person on a page or page spread at a time. You know, you can have multiple people in the account working on different spreads, just not on the same spread at the same time. So if you do have that, you know, one assigned to the left, one assigned to the right, have them both switch to a single page, and that will pretty much guarantee no save errors between those two on that spread. All right, so let's see. Last menu here is arrange. Tell you what, I'm gonna throw a few more shapes here on the page. And that way we can show you some of those. Actually, let's do triangular. Give those some colors here real quick. Okay, so things under the arrange menu here, what you would see, you've got lock and unlock. Now, if you need to lock items on a page, so I've got a locked triangle, you can unlock. Now locking is also a shortcut item. This is a little padlock up here, so you can quickly lock and unlock items. If we highlight multiple items at a time, under arrange, you're going to find group and ungroup. Now group and ungroup are also over here on as shortcuts as well. So if those three items together, we could group them. And that way we're able to move them all around as one. You know, just ungroup it. When we come down, we have our alignment options under arrange. Like, so for align horizontally, left, center, right. These are more, that is more or less if you need to align columns. So I'm going to just do a left. I'll throw these back out. Now your arrangement items, like align vertically or align horizontally, these are also going to show up under, there's another little shortcut arrange tool here. And these are the same options under here. So it's just a quick way to get to those. So align left, center, and right are going to be for aligning any items in a column. Top, middle, and bottom. Put those here. If you go, yeah, top, middle, or bottom, this will do your rows that are here. So I just wanted to go over, you know, a lot of these things real quick, just so you kind of have a feel of where some of the basic stuff, the basic tools are here to use. Now going through what we're going to do next from here, we're just going to go through and how would you approach just a candid activity page. Okay, so I'm going to put everything kind of back to default here. So when starting a page, we're going to go down through here, go through our tabs here real quick. First tab you have here is the Pages tab. And while you're working on your pages and designing, you need to quickly access another page here in the book. You'll use the Pages tab, and that way, you know, you'll just jump to another one of those pages and can start designing. Now, the next tab down is our Designs tab. Now the Designs tab is where we're going to find all of our pre-made templates. So if I go under, Designs and go under, there's a drop down. Sometimes it's going to show some of the last folders you've ever been here, but go under this drop down and you're going to see all the main different sections that are here. So you'll see custom, page surfer, click and go, advertising, portrait, and template exchange. Under what's custom, custom is anything that if you take anything of ours and you modify it and save it as your own, they're going to show up under custom and you'll see those under my templates. That way you can easily get back to them and show it. And I'll save one here if we do that. But what we're looking for today, we're going to go under the page surfer section. And under page surfer, you see that that's got about six categories to it. And these are all full, chock full of templates and design layouts for candid activity pages. Now, when looking at some of these categories, if I go under candids, candids is gonna have some of just more of our basic photo layouts. A lot of these are kind of the more basic layouts in the program. They'll have photo boxes. Some have a mixture of photo boxes and text that are there. So if we're going through your templates, and if there is one that you would like to use, just drag and drop them over. So I'm just going to pick this one, has a left and a right. It's not a whole spread template, but it kind of comes on like that. Like I said, there's many in here, different styles. When you bring a new template over, I'm hitting no on that, so it completely overwrites what is on there. So here's just another, when you get this retain existing content, said, do you want to retain existing content in the new template? If you're just looking to overwrite something that's completely there, you know, overwrite it completely, hit no, and it'll add the new layout in. So like I said, stuff that's under candidates are some really kind of very basic templates that are there. And these are really good to come in, and you can really kind of quickly come in. Some don't have many parts to them at all. Just drag and drop your stuff in. If I go back under my designs drop down, we got some other categories here, like clubs and organizations, openings and dividers, and sports. These are all great for candidate activity pages as well. They just have a lot more, a lot of these have a lot more going on with them, like a lot more kind of how the photo boxes are laid out and the structure of those. Let me bring some of those over here to the page. A lot of different styles that are here, a lot of different things that you can do. Now, if on some of these templates, here, let me just kind of go through, try to find one. So there are some neat things that are in here. Neat little things and little pieces are on some, a lot of these templates. But the main thing is just coming through here and finding stuff that, you know, if you're looking for different clubs pages, depending on what, there are templates for those. If you have group photos and that are here. Just tons and tons of different layouts that are there. If I go under sports, if you're looking, if I bring a sports one over. Now, a lot of these don't have to be for sports or for clubs. I mean, it doesn't, just because it's under the sports category doesn't mean that you have to have that for sports. If you see something like, you know, I like that layout, I just change the title to whatever else I need it to be, and then use it. You know, use it for whatever that page is. But there's just saying that there's a lot of neat stuff that's under here. I want to bring this over. No. Just trying to see if there was a different one that was there yesterday. Okay, so I'm just going to go ahead and bring this template and leave this template here on the page. There's a lot of little things that you can do. You know, when you have a template on a page, you can use the base layout that is here, but there is no part of any one of our templates that is set, like set in stone. Like, you are able to modify these templates even more. And just to kind of show you that, let's say that maybe I want to take one of these photo boxes and put like a big paragraph down here, but I want another big photo box that's up in this space. Well, I can select this text box and I can move it down to the bottom of the inside page margins. I'll start bringing this across. All right, so that's kind of where I want that. Now, you'll also kind of notice when I was adjusting that now there's a red X through this text box. If you ever get a red X while working with text box, that just means that not all of the type in that text box is showing. So if I start to bring this up more, you'll see that it goes away once all of it's showing. But I'm gonna leave it like this kind of for now, just because I don't know, maybe I don't know what text is going in here. And maybe the text I put in here won't use all of that. So I'm just gonna leave that kind of like that for now. I'm gonna go ahead and remove, I can just highlight and remove that other box. And say, now I'm just putting my candid page as a title. This could be any event that you have going on at the school. I just wanted to go ahead and stick a heading in real quick. And then, yes, I want to copy this box and I want to put it up in this area. I'm just going to go up to edit, copy, edit, paste. And there. bring that text box up a little bit here. Or maybe I can slide this line down a little bit or bring the photo box down. But there we go. We have basically, we just took one of our templates and modified it and brought another box in for a group photo. Maybe this would be really good for a club's page that you have or something. Now let's say that you like, hey, I really like my setup and I know I'm going to have to use this on a few other, because maybe we have many clubs that maybe the clubs might take up 4, 5, 6 pages, and you need to put this on, you know, at least put this style onto other pages. I'm going to go ahead and take off this other side real quick. So let's say that you have, you know, you modified it, you've got something of your own, you want to save it to use on other pages. Here's where we're going to go back and do File, Save as Template. You can give it a name. I'm just going to name this Candid Page, and I probably have a lot of them with that same name, so I'm just going to give it today's date here. Now, after you get the name in, then you get to pick which side of the template that you want. So I don't have anything over on the right anymore, so I don't need the right, I don't need both, so I just need to select left page and hit save. Now, once we save our own template, if we go back over to the Designs tab, our own template is going to be under, if we go back under the dropdown, we're going to go under Custom, and then we're going to find ours under My Templates. And yep, here's the one I just made today. I'll apply it. I'm just going to drag and drop it over. Now, one thing I will let you know, templates created on the left, when you bring them over to the right, they will flip and mirror. While a lot of times, a lot of people are great with how that does, if you are not wanting it to flip, though, you'll probably have to then, once you bring it over or basically set the template up, you know, and make yourself a right side that is there. But I just kind of wanted to point that out, that they're usually good going from, you know, left page, right page, to right. But if they do go to the other side, they will flip and mirror. And sometimes, and like I said, sometimes people like that. But if it is something that, you know, that's not the look you were going for, then this may be one, a case where it may be best to make a left and a right page for that. Here, let me clear this off here. So we got our template on. We've got, you know, a few photo boxes. We got some text. We got a shape to work with here. So as far as our page, let's kind of look and see, you know, adding stuff in and doing a little bit of formatting to kind of show you how you would approach when you get to that part. So if I go, like I said, to bring your images in, as long as you've uploaded them in the library and you have them in categories, you'll be able to come here to the Images tab, click the drop down, and you'll be able to find where these, you know, find your activity candidates or find your folders. Mine's just named Activity Candidates, so I'm going to click on that. Now, if your picture's off to the left here, to start putting them in, all you have to do here is just take your photo, drag and drop it over. So if you bring it over, if it highlights green, that means, and you let go. So when you, here, I'm going to undo that real quick. So you bring it over and it's highlighting green, that is telling you that that image is large enough and has high enough resolution to fill this spot. So it's green there. So if you let go of it, it's going to then fill in that whole spot there. Now, if you bring an image over and it goes red, that's just letting you know that that image is not, you know, it's not large enough to go into that spot, and you could use it in another. You may have to move it to another spot. Now, what happens if you bring an image over, it goes red, but you still let go of it? Well, it's not going to place in this photo box as here, but the program is going to place it in its own new photo box on top of that other photo box. So from here, I mean, you could either reposition or that if there's no other spot. But if, you know, I'm just going to delete this. But oftentimes the smaller photos, they may be good for, you know, if you don't have any other spot for them, they're good for a collage page. Or even in this one, while it doesn't work out for these, it does work out in these smaller ones that are right here. So I'm going to go ahead and drop it in place there. So that's how you're going to bring photos onto the page. So now that we have text, shape, and photos, one thing that you will notice is when you're working on these, there is, here, I'm going to deselect everything. So depending on which element you have selected on a page, so if you have a photo box selected, so whenever you click an element on a page, you're then going to get this toolbar that pops up just above the page. If you have a photo selected, or a photo in a photo box selected, it's going to give you the different photo, you know, formatting options that are here. So I mean, you could apply a stroke to the photo, which is, you know, the stroke is just a simple border that's going around it, or a simple frame. Starts off with a very low point number and it goes up to 9. So the higher the point number, the thicker that stroke will be. Bring it in here a little bit. So I made it just kind of a 2-point stroke there. The first little drop down will actually let you change the color of that. I'll make it something real kind of bright and show out here. I'll just make it red, just to kind of show you what that is. Other things you can do, there's a little magic wand, has format and effects. Under this, this is where you're going to find stuff like if you want to round corners on that image. If you need to lighten the image a little bit, there's tint. Or if you click on drop shadow and glow, let's see if we can pick a drop shadow color here, black. And we put some drop shadow on there just to make it look like it has a little bit of depth on the image, like kind of lifted from the page a little bit. But just all stuff you can do there under format and effects. There you go. Now, if you have a text box, well, here, I'll go simple here. If you have a shape selected, you have different shape editing options here to same the rounded corners. And let's say I want to change that away from yellow. Let's make that red, just to kind of match our border that we have here. All right, so photo gives you photo options. Shape gives you shape options, and if you select a text box, you'll then have all your text options for that box. Going through here, now as long as you've added fonts under the fonts area, and this is and that's an advisor only thing there. So if you're an advisor, definitely make sure you go under plan and then go into fonts, and your job, all jobs start with 2 default fonts to work with on your pages. Then from there, advisors can go under plan into fonts, and in the fonts area, you can toggle on more font styles to use on your pages. So definitely give that a look there. But here, back to here on the page, when we have a text box selected, you know, the first option that comes up, we can change the style that the font is in. So I can change that up to other ones that are here in the collection. Going through, those were styles of when they were bought on the page. So once that's on here, you're pretty good. Font size. So if I need to make that larger or smaller, if I wanted to change the color, go under this color drop down. Now the when you have a text box selected and you bring the color down, it is kind of pinned up here. I'm gonna unpin it so I can keep this and move it around. I'm just gonna bring it down here a little bit. All right, so with this text selected and we have our color palette up, the first option we have here, I'll tell you what, I'm going to change that to a different font style here real quick so we can see some of this better. When you bring up the color palette, the first thing it does, it wants to change is the text fill. So that's the color itself there. Text stroke is if you want to put a thin, you know, border on the stroke. So you can have a fill of red and then a stroke, you know, a different color there. So when you have the color palette up, text fill and text stroke, the two with the A, this is controlling just the text. Now, if you want to add a fill and a stroke on the text box, that's what these other two buttons are for. So if I wanted to fill in my shape, my text box, and let's say I just want to find a better color to match that with. Ooh, no. I'll just leave it at that, but that gives it the fill. And if we wanted to put a border on that box, we could do that as well by doing shape stroke. So all the little different options you have with text boxes there. In this case, I'm actually going to take the shape fill off. So I'm going to hit this little none there and go back under shape stroke and hit none. Okay, so I'm just back to our regular box that is there. But yeah, depending on what items you have here, this is what will change here on the page. If you make it bolder, italicized. Now, depending on which fonts that you use, you may not have all of the attributes. So some fonts may not have an italics option or underline or a bold option. Just that's how they, those fonts were created. All right, hit fit here, go back. Okay, so let's say we've got our type in, we have our photos in, you know, you've got everything, but now it's time to, you know, now it's time you want to add a background to the page just to kind of finish it off. Now, you can add a background anytime. Usually just as working on stuff, personal experience, I found that it's better just to get the core content in and then work on the formatting and the backgrounds later. You know, all the other, you know, the more fun stuff to do. Because if you get your core content in, that leaves you more time to play with the formatting and see what you like that's there. But now it's time to add a background. So I'm actually going to go back to the edit menu and I'm going to bring back up change background. Our little background menu that's here. So when working with this menu, when you first bring it up, you see that you'll actually kind of switch between left page and right page, just to, you know, depending on, you know, which side you're working on. So I'm gonna just stick to the right side for now. So this menu, if you want, you'll use this if you want to do, you know, through your pages, if you're not using like any kind of clip art backgrounds, let's say you just want a solid color background, we can go under background color and then choose, any one of those colors in our color palette that we have here. There we go. I'll go to the left page here. Now, if you're looking to add, if the theme backgrounds or any of the other backgrounds in the program, on the backgrounds menu here, you're going to click on choose image. And we get this little window here. We're going to go under the drop down. And you're going to look for clip art. And then you're going to click the arrow next to clip art to show the other categories that are under here. For our clip art or for backgrounds that go along with our covers. Once you're under clip art, you're going to go under by cover. And then you're going to look for the name of the color that you've, all these folders go along with the color that you've chosen. So if you chose the back to cool cover, there is back to cool folder that is here and it has those backgrounds that go with it. And just any one of the other themes that are here. Now, just because you have gone with a particular theme doesn't mean that you are stuck to that theme. If you go through here and see that maybe there's backgrounds that may also lend themselves to your book or to your pages that you're working on, feel free. All of this is open for you to use. So don't feel like you're stuck on just using one set of backgrounds or one set of clip art. I'm going to go under, let's see, what's a good one we can use here? Inkslosion. Those are really dark for my page here. So it's cute, but here I'll just do Zargon was nice. There's a lot here. I'm just trying to find, tell you what, I think I'm going to go down to Stonewash here. Those have some kind of some neat or just some basic backgrounds here. So I'm going to go with this one right here. So I'm just going to select background. I'm going to hit select. And then that background is going to apply to your page. So maybe I want to go with a different color that is there. Just switch it up. Actually, I like the other one a little bit better. Now, one thing that is here, once you bring the background in, if you still feel like the background is too bold, has a lot going on, you are able, you know, using the change background menu, you are able to tint these or lighten these a little bit. And that way, so here is all full color and this text down here is kind of hard to read, but notice if we bring that slider maybe up to about, you know, mid 40s, maybe 50 here, you'll see that this is lightened it and this text pops out a whole lot more there. So definitely a nice little handy menu to keep up while you're working. Like I said, it just kind of floats here and you can kind of push it off to the side or move it out of your way wherever you need it. But definitely you'll come in handy when you're adding backgrounds and also needing to lighten them. Kind of as we were going through, these are just kind of the things that you can do to build an Activity Candid page. There are a lot of different combinations you can do. There's a lot of templates. There are just a lot of customizations you can do from our own stuff to make this book just completely yours. So we've gone through, we added a template, we've added photos. We've shown how to do a little bit of formatting, add backgrounds in. One thing, I am going to hit save up here. One thing I probably should have mentioned earlier, definitely do this while you're working on your book, because last thing I'll show you here when you're working on your pages is what happens if you get to a point and you'd like to either restore something back or need to bring something back from an earlier point in time. So while you're working on your pages, definitely save often, just because the program keeps track of each and every saved change for each and every page. If you're here, if you're in as an advisor, advisors have one extra button that is down here, and that's the history. Now, as you're working on your pages, and why I say to save often is, let's say that you get all of your bare bones, you know, you got your text in, you got your photos in, but you have not done any formatting and you save. So let's say that then you start working on formatting backgrounds and you just get to a point where, you know what, I want to start over. I just want to go back to where I was before I applied this. And that way I can see, you know, try things a little differently. And, or maybe you accidentally erased something and hit saved and moved on and didn't notice it. Well, as long as you've been saving your changes, you can always come back to the history tab and restore that page from a previous time. So as you're coming through, it'll save your restore points. So the last time I hit save was earlier in our walkthrough or in our webinar here, and that's when I first started the page. So if I want to go back to where we started, all I have to do is drag and drop that page history over, and it puts that page back to where I just took that restore point from where we started about 10 minutes into this webinar. So definitely, as you're working, save often. You know, you never really want to go back on and do on something, but let's say if you do, you know, want to redo some formatting or go back to a previous point, Definitely check out that history tab. It'll have your changes there and drop them back on. So as far as today's webinar, go out through a build an activity page that is there. We've kind of gone over everything that we have. We do have a few minutes here that we can open this up to some Q&A. So if you do have any questions, feel free. If you want to unmute yourself and ask, we could do it that way. Or if you want to put your question in the chat line, I can address your question, and then kind of go over an answer there. But yeah, I got a few minutes here, so the floor is open. Okay. Well, I've kind of gone over things. Oh, here we go. One. Is there a forum for exchanging best practices and or templates? Not that I'm really aware of exchanging templates. As far as exchanging templates, there is. If you go under designs. Go under template exchange, this community. This is actually, we're not really sure how templates from this. I think this comes down from the bigger Jostens program and what their users can save, but it does filter into our version of the program. So these are some neat things that you could look through as far as community templates. Now, one thing I will say about templates that are here under community is if you see something in this community that you like, you really like, go ahead and toss it onto your pages and save it as your own template, because these tend to filter through and cycle through and get replaced fairly often. So what you may see today may not be there tomorrow. It may not be there a week from now. So I just want to put that up there. But no, good question on a forum. I know we have a blog email, our marketing does, with stuff like that that goes out to advisors. So you might check with your rep and see if there's something like that coming out soon. So hopefully we get you some best practices there. But as far as just kind of working on the program and here and these pages, what I would kind of do as best practice on starting an activity page is, you know, go through the templates first, see what is there, you know, bring that template on, kind of gauge where do you have enough photo box spots, or do you have enough material to fill all the spots in there. Get your text in, get your photos in, and then save, because then from there you've got your core content in. You're just then working on formatting and making it kind of, you know, changing colors, changing backgrounds from there. But no, good question there. Any other questions anyone has about today's webinar? Okay. Well, not seeing anything else come in, so I'm really hoping we kind of covered some stuff well, or at least got you guys to the point to where, you know, you're feeling more confident getting in here on what to work and where to find things and what tools to use here. So I think it looks like we may be good to go ahead and wrap up for the afternoon. So thank you everyone for joining us this afternoon. You know, hopefully these demonstrations of the functions Related to the creation of activity pages may help when it comes time when you're ready to do those pages. Definitely use templates already in the program, and building your own templates should save you some time and give your book continuity. So feel free. Actually, you're going to join us in a couple of weeks where we go over the final steps of the yearbook building process. So if you signed up for that, that'll be the final stages. So be sure to sign up for that one. That way we go over completing your pages, reviewing them, and submitting them into production. So until then, if you have any questions, please feel free to give us a call at 877-302-3140, or you can email us at memorybooktechsupport@jostens.com. So again, thank you, everybody. Glad you could take time out of your day to join us on this. So have a great rest of your afternoon. Take care. We'll see you.